to learn about software development and related fields. On Thursday, the Tech Cayman founders signed an agreement with government that lays out the framework for the work permit fees and other legal matters for establishing Tech Cayman-sponsored firms. For more on this story, I encourage you to look at the front page of the Cayman Compass for more details on that. Tech Cayman founders say that their venture is different than the Cayman Enterprise City setup that now exists. So again, for more details on that story, check out the front page of the Cayman Compass. Government begins to begins cutting red tape. We've been hearing a bit about this for quite a while. That was announced this week. From earlier this year, our acting governor, His Excellency, the Honorable Franz Manderson, actually made this a part of the five-year strategic plan for the Cayman Islands Civil Service. So it's all being rolled out now. Various departments, from Lands and Survey to Immigration, are making their services available to the general public on as it relates to many of their services offered to the public online, making it easier for and basically cutting red tape, just as it says. So, you know, the general public should be happier about those moves. I know that there's been 15 measures that have been laid out, and those that haven't been rolled out as yet are slowly being rolled out across the civil service, again, with the customer in mind and making business, doing business with the civil service easier for our customers. Another story on the front page of the Cayman Compass: Watermark condos approved for Seven Mile Beach. 10-story condos bridge approved with no objections. The story goes, the Central Planning Authority has approved plans for a $177 million 10-story luxury condo complex on Seven Mile Beach. The complex will be linked by a new pedestrian bridge over West Bay Road to a 3-story building featuring a restaurant, spa, and guest suites. The Watermark development includes 54 units, ranging in price from U.S. $5 million to U.S. $24 million. There were no objections, as I mentioned earlier, to the plans at Wednesday's planning meeting. Architect for the project developer said he had consulted extensively with neighboring property owners before finalizing the designs. The apartment will be built close to Public Beach between the Avalon and Harbor Heights condominium developments. So another story there for our listening public this morning. If you'd like to join us here on For the Record by phone, please give us a call at 1-800-534-8255. That's the toll-free number. Again, 1-800-534-8255. Digicel customers may also connect with us here on For the Record by calling us on 949-6990. Or you can send us a WhatsApp text or voice note on 925-3261. Again, thank you for joining us here on For the Record this morning. If you were to move over to page 2 of the Cayman Compass, there's a story that came out just yesterday. This one is headlined, Government Officials Express Support for Education Changes. I believe the first story may have came out on Wednesday rather than yesterday. And this story reads, the Legislative Assembly appears to be lining up behind changes in the Cayman Islands education system being proposed by the Education Council, and to tap into the budget surplus to pay for those changes. Both government and opposition leaders are expressing support. Opposition leader, the Honorable Ezra Miller, is calling on the government to work out ways to implement the changes. He says, quote, we're willing to sit down with the government. We're prepared to help the ministry with funding, end quote. Mr. Dan Scott, chairman of the Education Council, outlined some of the proposed changes, as I mentioned, on the front page of the Cayman Compass this past Wednesday. Among the changes being proposed are an increase in teacher salaries to a minimum of $5,000 per month, increasing autonomy for schools and classroom teachers, revamping the school curriculum and raising standards, and as well as incorporating year 12 in the government schools. On the last of these, Mr. Miller said he supports providing A-level preparation in the schools. He said he thinks the chances of the proposals being implemented is very good. So another positive story there on the second page of the Caymanian Compass, or the Cayman Compass, rather, on page 2. Sports-related story over on page 5. The Cayman men's golf team actually won the Horman Cup at the 2018 Caribbean Amateur Golf Championships held at the North Sound Golf Club recently. A big, big congratulations to them. The picture basically says it all. They're holding their Cayman flags proudly with smiles on their faces. So they are considered the Caribbean Championships. Again, congratulations to them. I also understand they'd like to congratulate the Cayman ladies team on an excellent performance against very strong opposition. The men actually defeated some of the larger countries such as the Dominican Republic, Trinidad and Tobago, Puerto Rico, Jamaica, Bahamas, Barbados, as well as the U.S. Virgin Islands. Again, a real positive story there coming out of the sports arena. Over on page 6, I'm sure that everyone out there has been aware that the RCIPS is busy with their second recruitment drive for 2018. The last time that I spoke with the RCIPS, which was earlier this week, they said that the recruitment drive was going pretty well. But on page 6, they've announced that they've now opened the recruitment to foreigners. And let me explain that before, you know, any red flags are raised. It's non-Caymanians who have legally resided in the Cayman Islands for at least the past 4 years. They will be allowed to apply for the Royal Cayman Islands Police Service's latest recruitment drive. I mean, we all know that the RCIPS has also always strived to hire as many Caymanians as possible. We know that the pool of persons who would actually qualify, as well as those who are interested in the career in law enforcement, is very small in the Cayman Islands. Thus, I'm sure this is one of the reasons why they've opened it up to a wider section or target audience within our local community. All right, so we're going to take a break here on For the Record in just a second. Again, just a reminder to give us a call at the toll-free number of 1-800-534-8255 with any questions or anything you'd like to discuss here on the show this morning. Digicel customers, call 949-6990, or you can text us on WhatsApp or send us a voice note at 925-3261. And we'll be right back with more here on For the Record.
The Cayman Islands boasts of a long, colorful, and rich history. In tribute to our roots, Radio Cayman, the voice of the Cayman Islands, is pleased to bring you the historical vignette series, sponsored by Cayman National Bank. Visit Cayman National Bank today for all of your financial needs. The Cayman Islands, he hath founded it upon the seas.
As Caymanian turtlers developed a unique maritime folklore based on trade, crews swapped stories about famous catches and adventures. One such story relayed by famous Caymanian, Captain Ali Ebanks of West Bay, took place in 1942. Captain Ali, while working on the turtling grounds northeast of Mosquito Key, came across a man in a catboat full of green turtles. The man was seeking assistance in shipping 5 of his best turtles home for his family. As was customary, the 5 turtles were marked for identification and loaded onto the schooner Lydia E. Wilson for a shipment back to Grand Cayman, where they were placed in a crawl to await the man's return home. However, a storm struck the shoreline, and the turtles were washed back out to sea. 12 days after the storm began, the same man approached Captain Ali, concerned about the welfare of the schooner Lydia E. Wilson. The man just that morning had caught one of the very same turtles that a few weeks prior had been shipped to Grand Cayman. Across Mosquito Key, the fisherman grew worried about the fate of the Lydia E. Wilson until a schooner sailed through one morning and confirmed that she was in fact safe at the anchor in West Bay, and explained the flooded crawl and the lost turtles. It was finally concluded that the green turtle, once free from the crawl in Grand Cayman, had swam 400 miles across the Caribbean Sea in only 12 days, right back to the very same rock he had been caught the first time.
Information from this historical vignette was sourced from the Maritime Heritage of the Cayman Islands by Roger C. Smith.
Radio Cayman's Historical Facts Vignettes are proudly brought to you by Cayman National, with branches on all three Cayman Islands. Visit Cayman National Bank today for all of your financial needs.
Why rush around paying bills when you can pay most of your bills online? Cayman National offers an extensive list of service providers. Visit CaymanNational.com and log on to our personal or business online banking systems. Not an online banking customer? Contact their customer support team on 949-8300 for more information.
Did you hear that Vant Motors has your sale going on now? And you get your choice on the money you'll save on your new car or truck?
My sale? My choice? Really?
Yeah, and they have lots of cars on sale, some up to $7,000 off.
Sounds pretty good.
It gets even better. You can choose to take the full discount, or you can get some or all of it as cash back.
Extra cash back would be great.
Exactly, and you can even use the savings to extend your warranty or service plan, so you'll drive worry-free for years longer.
Another good idea.
If you want to upgrade with something like a new roof rack or backup camera, you can choose that too.
Wow, I get to choose?
Yeah, that's why it's your sale, your choice. Going on now at Vant Motors on Walker's Road, while stocks last.
At Seaboard Marine, customers often ask us questions about their shipments.
Can you explain what a less than container load is for shipments and what your minimum charge is?
Sure. A less than container load, or LCL, is any overseas shipment that does not require the full space of a container. At Seaboard, we have great rates for small packages. Just let us know the dimensions of your package and we'll help you out from there.
Shipping shore to shore, Seaboard.
Are you kidding me?
What's wrong?
I ran out of my meds and I have an interview in about an hour.
Why not call CTMH Doctors Hospital Pharmacy? They'll be able to help.
You think so?
Absolutely. Their pharmacists are brilliant for fast, efficient, and professional service.
CTMH Doctors Hospital Pharmacy provides you with more than just prescriptions. We strive to make your health our concern. We recognize the complexities of pharmaceuticals and the need to personalize your care. That is why we offer personalized one-on-one counseling. Call us today or visit our website at caymanpharmacy.com. Mm.
Wow, looks good. What is that?
Chicken char.
Mm. What did you just say to me?
Chicken char.
I am not a chicken
Whoa, I said chicken share. It's from KFC. Bucket of 12 hot wings, 6 pieces of chicken, or 8 tenders. KFC chicken share. Just $12 each.
Oh.
Want some chicken, tenders, or hot wings?
You're sharing your chicken share with me?
The new chicken share from KFC. Just $12 each. And it's finger-licking good. Dine at KFC Baytown Plaza, KFC Shedden Road, or KFC at the Strand.
System one loaded.
1-800-534-8255. What is on your mind when it comes to the government, independence, and the opposition? Issues that matter to you. 1-800-534-8255. Waiting to hear from you. For the Record, with your host, Orit Connor.
And welcome back to For the Record. I'm Donna Bush on this beautiful Friday morning, sitting in for Mr. Orit Connor, who I hope is getting some well-needed rest or relaxation, fun, whatever. yes, so I will be here with you all every day, every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, that is, until the 22nd of August. Again, thank you for joining us here on For the Record this morning. Please give us a call at our toll-free number, 1-800-534-8255. Our Digicel customers can give us a call at 949-6990. If you'd like to send us a WhatsApp text or voice note, you can do that by calling 925-3261. Before I went to the break, I was just updating the listening public on the recruiting process that's now taken place within the Royal Cayman Islands Police Service, the second one for 2018. I did mention that I know that they do try their best to recruit as many Caymanians into the service as they can. They have now actually opened the recruitment up, which was supposed to be today's deadline. Actually, we're going to stick a pin there and take one caller. Caller, welcome to For the Record this morning. Do you have a question or a comment that you'd like to discuss with us here this morning?
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
Good, good. Just want to make two sort of community announcements. And one is, remember, the Civil Service Association will be in Cayman Brac tomorrow for the back to school.
Awesome, awesome, awesome.
Yes, and it's from 9 till 1 at the Ashton Russell Center. And okay. just letting, you know, members know to come early to get the best choices of the bags and goodies.
Okay.
And then the second one is that there is a farmer's market at the West Bay Heritage Village, which is right next to Aid Bush Field. And that's tomorrow from 8 till 1. And, you know, just telling people that they can come out and get their fresh fruits and vegetables. We're going to have our farmers there. So this is a new thing for West Bay.
Awesome.
Just wishing everybody a happy weekend and, you know, God bless the Cayman Islands.
Okay, thank you so much, caller. Okay, so the caller was just giving us some good information there. The Cayman Islands Civil Service will be on Cayman Brac tomorrow for its back-to-school drive from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. at the Aston Ruddy Center. Civil servants there on the BRAC, if you're listening, or if you can share the information with fellow civil servants on the BRAC, you're encouraged to go and, you know, take advantage of being a member of the Civil Service Association on the BRAC tomorrow. As well, there's a farmer's market where you'll be able to get fresh fruits and vegetables at the Ed Bush Field in West Bay tomorrow from 8 in the morning to 1 p.m. These are both great things that are happening. And I'm so happy that the caller called to give us that information. I believe it sounded like Zita Mae Bodden. So thank you, Zita, for that information for our listeners this morning. And I'll, of course, go over that information again in just a little bit. So, yes, I was talking about the police open recruitment story on the page 6 of the Cayman Compass. They've opened up the recruitment to residents who have resided here in the Cayman Islands for the past 4 years. And, of course, you know, they have to go through a whole host of qualifying criteria before they can actually become a recruit. The story does go on, though, to say the deadline for recruitment, I know, was for today, August the 10th. That has been extended to August 24th. So this gives those the other target audience, which would be the residents who are now 4 years resident here in the Cayman Islands, the opportunity until August 24th to apply. Police Commissioner Derek Byrne said so far 82 suitable applicants have sought positions in the recruitment class, but the RCIPS wanted to widen the pool of potential officers. Our express objective, he says, continues to be the recruitment of Caymanians first and foremost. Only those places in a recruit class not filled by a Caymanian will be open to non-Caymanians. Now, through expanding the minimum criteria in this way, we will strive to represent some groups in the islands that are currently underrepresented in the service, while also adding varied skills, including language skills, to our day-to-day working capacities. Previously, only Caymanians and non-Caymanians who have permanent residence through marriage to Caymanians could apply. Now, the recruitment is available to applicants ages 18 to 40. There are also basic fitness, educational, and background requirements for potential officers. So anybody that's listening out there this morning who've resided in the Cayman Islands for 4 years, who is a Caymanian or who has permanent residency through marriage, you know, these are the people that are being encouraged to go and fill out their applications to become a law, you know, an officer of the law with the Royal Cayman Islands Police Service. Again, application forms can be found at rcips.ky. If you go on there, it's a great site. It's very user-friendly, so it's easy for you to just maneuver your way around and find that application form, again, at rcips.ky. So a good story there. Over on page 9 of the Cayman Compass, I don't know if our listening public remembers, just recently it was announced that the Immigration Department had started a month-long amnesty. The amnesty was basically to give various people in the Cayman Islands who may be here illegally, give them the opportunity to do things above board and basically turn themselves in to say, look, I've overstayed. I don't want to be penalized for it. But, you know, just to handle things the way that it should be handled in the right way. But on page 9 of the Compass, it says 4 overstayers identified during the amnesty. That's thus far. Of course, the amnesty doesn't end until 3 p.m. on August 31st. If I remember correctly, the last time that there was an amnesty of this type held in the Cayman Islands was back in like 2009, 2010, somewhere around there. Actually, I'm looking at the story and it says the last time the Immigration Department attempted an amnesty was in mid-2010, during which time more than 40 people ranging in age from 6 months to 80 years old were deported from the Cayman Islands. At the time, immigration officials were concerned about so-called work permits of convenience, those for individuals who have irregular or no work offered by the permit holder. So the story ends by saying that the Immigration Department actually reported that 336 people were arrested between July of 2016 and November of last year, 2017, for the offense of overstaying or assisting another person to overstay. So, you know, the general public out there who's listening, you may know somebody who's, you know, not here legally. This is a great opportunity for them to do things, you know, in the right way. They can basically get in touch with immigration and explain their situation. I guess I don't know what the process is, but they would go in and probably speak to them and take it from there. But again, yeah, this is a great time for people who have broken law so far to basically, you know, get a break from being penalized for it. Over on page 10 of the Cayman Compass, there are several stories here, which I find are very interesting, fun stories. Cayman sending 2 teams to culinary contest. Now, I know that recently Mr. James Jamo Miles, somebody who really is to be applauded for his work with young people in our community and who is part of the youth services unit within the government. He has been instrumental recently in helping young aspiring chefs to raise money to compete at a Caribbean-wide competition, culinary competition. I think it's being held in Barbados, but let's just scan the story real quick. It says the Caribbean is about to get a taste of Cayman home cooking. A pair of enterprising young teams from Cayman will compete in the Caribbean Junior Dueling Challenge that takes place next week in Barbados, and they will be serving a signature local dish as part of the proceedings. Now, I know, in fact, that these young people were trying to raise funds. If you're out there listening and you can, you know, provide any funding to these young teams of aspiring chefs, get in touch with James Miles and do what you can. Every bit counts, I'm sure. It's expensive to take these kids on to these competitions. You want them to go prepared as best as they can to represent the Cayman Islands. So do your part if you can. You know, every bit adds up. If you're a business owner out there or you're just an individual who, you know, can open your heart and open your pockets to help these young people to go away and represent the Cayman Islands at this culinary dueling championship next week. That would be just awesome. You can get in touch with James Miles. He's at the Youth Services Unit, or you can call the government building, and I'm sure that they will be able to put you in touch with him. Another story related to young people is the National Trust Back to School Recycling Initiative. They've just started a new program. I'll tell you more about that in just a few minutes, but right now we're going to take a break here on For the Record. Please stay with us.
Radio Cayman Time Check is now 7:59. This time check is brought to you courtesy of our friends at Price Right.
Price Right is Grand Cayman's warehouse shopping superstore, making your dollar go further with huge savings and no membership fees. Get more of the things you use every day at the right price. But it's not just grocery and health and beauty. Price Right has a full range of products from office to automotive, patio furnishings to kitchen appliances, and even electronics. And since warehouse prices mean savings for you, everything is priced right at Priced Right, Grand Cayman's warehouse shopping superstore.
the voice of the Cayman Islands.
89.9 FM in Grand Cayman and 93.9 FM in Cayman Brac and Little Cayman.
Silver wings shining in the sunlight.
Radio Cayman.
Access. Information.
Your community. News and information. Radio Cayman is your choice, your voice for today's biggest news.
Radio Cayman.
With your latest news, I'm Carsley Fuller. Government and Tech City Cayman sign on the dotted line on Thursday. The plan is to get the ball rolling on a platform that will be focused on helping businesses set up in Cayman, but also to create jobs and transfer knowledge to the Caymanian people. Minister for Commerce, Planning and Infrastructure, the Honorable Joseph Hughes, says the agreement is an extension and complement to the success of the Cayman Enterprise City project.
While this agreement does not make Tech Cayman a special economic zone, it does grant concessions that will facilitate the ease of operations, enabling the continued growth of the tech industry within the Cayman Islands. This is an opportunity for the Cayman Islands to become what we hope will be the Silicon Valley of the Caribbean, and we look forward for the successes to come.
Tech City Cayman representative, software developer, Silicon Valley entrepreneur Samir Mitra tells Radio Cayman it's been 5 years in the making and they're looking forward to focusing on technology and innovation.
We are not trying to co-locate companies so that we can offer them real estate or commercial real estate. We're really focused on technology and innovation. So we're really building a digital innovation platform to really create a digital economy for Cayman. The digital economy is going to be the future.
The company also plans to set up shop in Cayman Brac, which will provide residents a unique option for employment and a new career path for young people. In other news,
well, we really got to be thankful for our chairman, our board chairman, Mr. Donovan Ebanks.
That's National Roads Authority Director Edward Howard giving some appreciation to NRA Chairman Donovan Ebanks, who felt the need to reach out to the prison service to ask for help from inmates to help with cleanup activities along the sides of Cayman's roads.
There's always these areas that we can't essentially get to, you know, kind of the overlooked sections. And then so he thought it, you know, would be a very good idea to utilize, you know, those prisoners who were able to assist. So really, we got to be thankful for him reaching out to the prison service.
This week, the NRA and members of Her Majesty's Prison Service met up outside the Bonnetown Civic Center for the official launch of the partnership between both government bodies. Financial Services Minister, the Honorable Tar River, says she's imploring more agencies to collaborate with the prison service to help Cayman look spotless.
It's absolutely vital for the other government agencies, statutory authorities, and private sector organizations to reach out to the prison service, as the NRA has done, in order to establish these very practical programs that actually address a need, and that is to help to keep our environment clean and pristine to the best extent possible, and we know this is certainly an ongoing task.
Minister Rivers says this is a key initiative in fighting recidivism. And three new trustees have been added to the Public Service Pensions Board. Ward Connor, Cherie Ebanks, and Robin Ellison will spend the year working on priority matters such as an increased focus on member service delivery, a review of plan risk management, and further assessment of financial controls and investment monitoring. The new trustees underwent a full day of training and orientation earlier this week to get well-versed in the PSPB-specific legislation and pension schemes. Their first formal trustee meeting happens later in the month. Now with a check of international news, here's the BBC, who will take us out of the newscast. I'm Carsley Fuller from Radio Cayman's newsroom.
BBC News with Jerry Smith. Crowds of reporters have gathered outside Zimbabwe's constitutional court in Harare, where the opposition MDC is due to mount a legal challenge to the presidential election. The party claims ballot boxes were stuffed and figures inflated to give Emmerson Mnangagwa his narrow victory. A strike by pilots with the budget airline Ryanair has forced the cancellation of around 400 European flights. 75,000 passengers are affected, but Ryanair says most of them have been put on alternative flights. The Turkish currency, the lira, has continued its plunge against the dollar, losing 14% of its value at one point on Friday. The losses were fueled by concerns about President Recep Tayyip Erdogan's influence on monetary policy and the poor state of Turkey's relations with the US. UN aid officials have condemned an attack in Yemen in which at least 29 children died when their school bus was hit. The Saudi-led coalition said its airstrikes were legitimate military actions that targeted Houthi rebels. But the UN's children's agency, UNICEF, described what happened as unconscionable. An armed gang has killed at least 10 people in a bank robbery in southern Nigeria. The gang first raided a police station in Igara in Edo State to steal weapons before going on to rob two banks. BBC News.
Access. Information.
What's happening in your community? News and information, music and more.
Radio K-Man.
You can find us. www.radiokman.gov.ky. Like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Radio K-Man is your choice, your voice for today's biggest news.
Radio K-Man.
This August at Kirk Home Center, protect your electronics with Power Surge Protector Strips for $8.59. Keep current this hurricane season with a portable generator for $286.79. Chef up your favorite dishes in the 14-piece Tefal Nonstick Cookware Set for $80.69. Store yard items away and create seating space with a deck box for
$89.49. Kirk's Home Center, you got a great deal.
Hey, are those new glasses on Will?
Yeah, we went to Optical Outlook.
Wham, bam, easy exam. Finally, an exam he could pass. And we have the glasses the next day. Easiest part of our back-to-school shopping for sure.
Book your child's exam today at Optical Outlook. Call 746-2020. Save 50% off a complete pair of glasses with any student eye exam. From now until August 31st. Come see the difference with Optical Outlook. Located in the Caymanian Village. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram.
In financial news, world shares fell ahead of the release of U.S. consumer price data, with European benchmarks sliding in early trading on concerns over Turkey. Keeping score, Germany's DAX fell 1.2% to 12,519, and the CAC 40 in France fell 1% to 5,448. Britain's FTSE 100 sank 0.5% to 7,706. The future contract for the Dow Jones Industrial Average was down 0.4% to 25,391, and the contract for the S&P 500 lost 0.4% to 2,841. Looking at Asia's day, Japan's Nikkei 225 index lost 1.3% to 22,298, and Hong Kong's Hang Seng gave up 0.8% to 28,366. The Shanghai Composite Index recovered from early losses to end flat at 2,795. In South Korea, the Kospi lost 0.9% to 2,282. India's Sensex fell 0.3% to 37,908. In energy, benchmark U.S. crude oil lost 18 cents to $66.63 a barrel in electronic trading on the New York Mercantile Exchange. It dipped 0.2% to $66.81 a barrel in New York. Brent crude, the standard for international oil prices, gave up 15 cents to $71.92 a barrel. It lost 0.3% to $72.07 per barrel in London. And in currencies, the dollar fell to 110.94 yen from 111.09 yen after the report of strong second quarter growth data. The euro fell to 1.1443 from 1.1526.
Hi, this is Derry Dakers Lee, chairperson for the Miss Cayman Islands Universe Committee. The committee is inviting you to our pageant on 11th August at the Westin. Dress code is formal. Join us for cocktails at 6 p.m. The pageant will start at 7 p.m. Tickets for adults and children can be purchased for $75 at Sand Angels and Falky Tangs. Come out and show your support for the seven young ladies vying for the title of Miss Cayman Islands Universe. The winner will proudly represent us at the Miss Universe pageant in December. See you at the Westin on August 11th.
Did you know that improperly packaged garbage can cause injury to DEH garbage collection crews? Help preserve the health of our collectors by ensuring that your household garbage container weighs no more than 40 pounds when full and has proper handles to facilitate easy lifting. Avoid placing broken glass, syringes, or other sharp items with your regular household garbage. Instead, dispose of these items at the 24-hour drop-off site located at the entrance of the Georgetown landfill. Do your part. Keep our communities clean and our collectors safe. For more tips on proper waste handling, visit DEH website at www.deh.gov.ky.
Your weather update after 8 is brought to you by Brandsource Home Gallery, creating elegant bathrooms with European-style fixtures and fittings.
All right, good morning, K-Man. Let's take a look at your latest weather update, courtesy of our friends at Brandsource. Present temperature now 84 degrees Fahrenheit, relative humidity 88%. Winds are out of the northeast at 18 knots. Barometric pressure still holding at 29.97. Synopsis for this morning: moderate winds and seas are expected across the Cayman area for the next 24 hours in association with a high system over the western Atlantic Ocean. So the forecast for today: partly cloudy skies with a 20% chance of showers. Temperatures will rise to the low 90s. Winds will be east to northeast at 10 to 15 knots, and seas will be moderate with wave heights of 3 to 5 feet. Later on tonight, partly cloudy skies with a 30% chance of late night showers and possible thunder. Temperatures will fall to the upper 70s. Winds will be east to northeasterly at 10 to 15 knots, and seas will be moderate with wave heights of 3 to 5 feet. High tide is kicking in the next 8 minutes at 8:18. It's going to be low at 2:45 this afternoon and high again at 9:17 tonight. For tomorrow, low tide is at 3:33 a.m., high at 9:12 a.m., low at 3:29 p.m., and high at 9:56 p.m. Sunset this Friday evening is at 6:55, sunrise for tomorrow morning at 6:06, and the outlook is for similar weather through Sunday morning. That's your latest weather right here on Radio Cayman.
Your weather update after 8 is brought to you by Brandsource Home Gallery, creating elegant bathrooms with European-style fixtures and fittings.
Babe, not tonight. I need to be rested for all-day meetings tomorrow.
What are you talking about? I was almost asleep.
You keep poking me, and I can't sleep.
That's the mattress spring I keep telling you about. Not me. We really need to get a new mattress.
Tossing and turning, back hurting, can't sleep? It might be time to turn to your old mattress and go to bed with a new one. Browse the huge mattress showroom at Brandsource Home Gallery and pick the perfect mattress today. With mattresses to suit every budget, Brandsource Home Gallery stocks a wide selection of sizes and styles, like Pillow Top and gel memory foam. So stop tossing and turning and sleep better tonight with a new mattress from Brandsource Home Gallery, Dorsey Drive, Industrial Park.
All right, taking a look at traffic conditions. East-West Arterial looking quite good. And of course, Linford Pearson Highway is moving, as well as Crewe Road, of course, with the usual delays at the traffic intersection on Smith Road. And of course, looking at the Esterly Tibbetts Highway and the roundabout in the vicinity of A.L. Thompson, very much busy, but traffic is moving at a comfortable pace. Godfrey Nixon Way, Eastern Avenue looking good. Shen Road getting a little busy, but traffic is moving quite good. West Bay Road also looking quite busy with a good, healthy flow of traffic. Not too much to complain about this morning time. You should make it to work on time. And kids are getting up for school. If you're heading out on vacation right now, roads are clear. If you're heading to the airport to catch your flight, have a safe trip and enjoy that vacation. Of course, we got your latest sport report coming up and back into For the Record.
From happy beginnings to happy ever after,
BritK protects your lifestyle with the best insurance cover at the best possible price.
Health insurance with far-reaching benefits.
95% of claims settled in 5 days.
Low-cost life insurance.
And investments.
Security in retirement.
With a custodian pension plan.
For happy beginnings and a happy ever after,
visit BritK.ky or call 949-8699.
BritK, where people come first.
In local sports, the Cayman Islands girls under 15 national football team dropped their first points in international play this week as the local young ladies lost 4-0 to St. Lucia in Group E at the CONCACAF Girls Under 15 Championships in Bradenton, Florida. The Caymanian youngsters got off to an extremely difficult start, conceding goals in the second and 11th minutes and a third in the 22nd, which triggered a number of changes just before the halftime whistle. In the 31st minute, Alexia Brumfield, Cheyenne Windsor, and Lily Powery entered the field of play for Ray Diane Ebanks-Hides, Kaylee Ebanks, and Riley Doyle, respectively. St. Lucia added a fourth in the 35th minute from which the Cayman Islanders would never recover. Ethana Villa-Boss and Kayla Bradley were sent on in the 36th minute to replace Casey Golding and Nasaria Whitaker, but with time running out, the deficit was too difficult to overcome. In the 65th minute, the Cayman Islands made their sixth and final sub as Shawane Finn replaced Hannah Scott. A somewhat disappointed but very proud assistant coach, Shakina Bush, said, quote, "Our girls tried their best to play their normal game, but we could not find our fluency and didn't take advantage of the few chances we created." The Cayman Islands face Group D runner-ups Barbados today in a consolation game and return home on Sunday. In international sports, Monica Abbott had 18 strikeouts and the United States defeated Australia 3-1 today in the playoffs of the Women's World Softball Championship. Abbott gave up a game-tying solo home run to Stacey Porter in the fourth inning, but was solid the rest of the way, facing only seven hitters in the last two innings. The U.S. will next face either Puerto Rico or Japan in the tournament, which also doubles as a qualifier for the 2020 Tokyo Olympics.
Initiating system.
For information that matters, For the Record, with Orit Connor, continues right now on Radio Cayman.
And welcome back to For the Record. If you're just joining us on this beautiful Friday morning here in the Cayman Islands, I'm Donna Bush in for Mr. Orit Connor this Friday through to the 22nd of August. We have a number of callers on the line. Welcome to For the Record to our first caller this morning. Do you have a question or a comment that you'd like to make this morning?
Hi, good morning. This is Dari Dakers-Lee from the Cayman Islands Committee.
Morning. Welcome, Dari.
But this morning, I just would like to encourage everyone to come on down to the Westin on Saturday, which is tomorrow at 7 p.m., to watch the seven beautiful young ladies vying for the title of Miss Cayman Islands Universe. And obviously, they will go on to represent us at the Miss Universe pageant in Thailand in December.
But, well, it sounds like exciting times. I mean, you and I both have experienced, great things from being part of pageants, both personally in competing, as well as being members of the current Miss Cayman Islands Universe Committee. And I would just like to, make a point this morning that, our role is to help to develop each and every one of these young women that come through the system. And I'm just so excited for each and every one of them tomorrow night. It's going to be an experience of a lifetime.
Absolutely. And, the Miss Cayman pageant, sometimes, people perceive it to be all about the glitz and the glamour. But what it is, it provides a platform for young Caymanian ladies to further their education, to build their network, their self-confidence, and then create opportunities for success, which ultimately paves the way for them to become leaders in the community. And as you mentioned, Donna, the committee's goal is to provide these young ladies with skills to strive for excellence. And sometimes, as we know, it can be challenging and sometimes even discouraging. But the end result is always rewarding, because if you look back at past title holders, even first runners up, look at yourself, Donna. They're always, I can't think of any past title holder or even a runner up that are not successful, and they're actually playing an integral role in the community.
Yes.
So this in itself attests, to the committee. And what the committee has been doing over the years in developing young ladies.
Yeah, and it takes a lot of work and dedication. And each one of these young women, on all levels, have dedicated their time in trying to improve themselves in whichever way that they can. The committee puts a lot of hard work and voluntary hours into getting this pageant, off the ground every year. A lot of work goes on behind the scenes. It's not an easy task, but for me personally, and I know I can speak for yourself and others on the committee, it is such a reward to see the end result, which is each one of those young women going out there and just shining in every which way that they can, and just
Absolutely.
Growing. And when they tell you that, they so appreciate the fact that you've dedicated your time and your energy to making them, helping them to be better. I think it's for me, it's such a fulfilling feeling.
That is the satisfaction and the reward and the fulfillment then that you feel when you actually get that feedback from these contestants, that you have inspired them, that you mean so much to them, that they have a whole, you know, brand new life again. And so that is really what we're striving, I think, as a community on the whole, not just the Miss Cayman Islands Committee, but the community on the whole should be striving for that.
Yes.
For our young people.
Yes.
It is very important to continue to uplift them and help them, as I mentioned before, to become an integral part of our community.
The committee, as
you talked about earlier as well, we provide, you know, training. We groom these young ladies to, become role models in terms of, I mean, they've been trained in by the Toastmasters. Special thanks to them, actually,
for
in public speaking and runway training. We had a past contestant, actually, assisting this year, Mahalia Seymour. So, you know, they want to become involved in the pageant even after, you know, they compete as well. And then the title holder then will go on for further training in order to, you know, enable them to compete at an international standard.
Yes. So just remind the listening public again, Derry, when it all takes place.
It's this Saturday, 11th August. Cocktails will start at 6 p.m. and the pageant will begin at 7 p.m. So come out and support your favorite contestant. Tickets are available at Sand Angels and Funky Times for $75. It's at a great location this year. The dress code is formal. So we're really looking forward to seeing you. Of course, seating is limited.
Yes, seating is limited, but I would imagine that persons can buy tickets at the door at the Westin as well when they come. Hopefully,
yeah,
there'll be tickets left over for people to buy. All right, well, Derry, thank you so much for taking the time this morning and joining us here on For the Record and just encouraging the listening public to come out and support our Miss Cayman Islands Universe 2018 contestants tomorrow.
Thank you, Donna.
No worries. You too. So there was another story that we were discussing earlier, page 10 of the Cayman Compass. Actually, we're going to go to another call. Welcome to For the Record this Friday morning. Do you have a question or a comment you'd like to make?
Yes. Good morning, Miss Donna.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, you know who this is?
I don't want to get it wrong, so I'd say no.
All right. This is Mark Sum. Lennox Mark.
Hi. You're over on the BRAC. Oh, my gosh.
Yes.
I wish I had some of your bread now.
Really?
Yes, I wish I had some, yes. So what's going on? What's going on over in the BRAC?
Pretty good. You know, the weather's nice today. No rain yet, but hopefully we'll get some later on.
Okay.
Donna, Miss Donna.
Yes.
It's so nice to hear a woman's voice. No disrespect to the guys that be on there, OC and Sterling and things like that. But, you know, I think Radio Cayman need a woman segment, a segment there that a woman is in charge of. Because for some reason, I think, you know, some of the messages that need to be put out to the public, I think you would be the perfect woman for that, you know? And I'm rooting for a Donna Bush segment, you know?
Okay. All righty then. Just put it out there in the atmosphere. Let's see what happens.
Yeah. It's so nice to hear you.
And it's nice for you to call, too. Thank you so much for that, Lennox. Yeah, I really appreciate that.
Listen carefully. Hello?
Yes, I'm here. Go ahead.
Yeah, I have a favor to ask you. In the Constitution, our Constitution, on page 21, on the section 15, it concerns property. And if you would be so kindly to read that section, if you have got a couple of minutes this morning, sometime. It's about property and about the government using people's property. So if you could just do that for me, please.
Okay. You know? I will definitely try my best. You said page 21, section 15 of the Constitution. On it. I am on it.
Thank you so much, Donna.
You're very welcome. Have a wonderful weekend.
Yeah, and you must come up to the BRAC pretty soon now.
I will.
Love to see you.
I definitely will.
Okay, then.
Take care. Thanks for the call. Okay, thanks to Mr. Moxham there, as well as he's over in the BRAC, as well as Derry Dacres-Lee from the Miss Cayman Islands Committee, telling us about tomorrow's Miss Cayman Islands Universe Pageant 2018 taking place at the Westin Resort and Spa on West Bay Road starting at 7 o'clock. Showtime is at 7. Cocktail hour is at 6 o'clock. Tickets are $75 and are available at Sand Angels as well as Funky Tang's and at The Gate as well. So before I went to the break, quite a while ago, we were talking about a story on page 10 about the culinary team of young people who are competing in Barbados next week. Now, the story simply says that the competition is next week, but I've been informed by one of our listeners that, in fact, the young people, I made a call out for the community to really lend their financial support to these young people to ensure that they're well prepared as best as they can be with the expenses related to traveling and competing. But I've been informed that, in fact, the team left this morning for Barbados. And the reason that they've left 5 days ahead of competition, which is on the 15th and 16th of August, is because they have to attend some workshops before the competition. I still want to encourage, though, the listening public, if they can, to lend any financial support that they can to these young people, because they are going to come back and they will go to competition again. So, you know, just because they've already left for this particular competition doesn't mean that you can't support them anyway. I would still encourage you to reach out to Mr. James Miles when he's back on island and lend any support that you can financially to these young people, because, again, we have some great aspiring chefs on our hand here in the Cayman Islands. You can read the story on page 10 of the Cayman Compass, but I'd just like to give a shout out to the team of young people who have gone to compete. Cayman's team A consists of 16-year-old Bradley McLaughlin and 15-year-old Ayanna Davis Eden, while team B will be 19-year-old Brittany Bodden and 15-year-old Joshua McLean. They're all participating in the competition. And our ages, as you had just heard, between 13 and 20. Chef Carlos Sierra of the Ritz-Carlton Grand Cayman will serve as coach for both teams. So again, please, if you can lend any financial support to these team of young aspiring Caymanian chefs for any future competition, please, I encourage you to do so. It's just a great thing to be a part of. Also, I was mentioning that the National Trust has just become involved and a back-to-school recycling initiative. And the story basically is that the trust is helping kids understand the importance of protecting the environment. The way that they're doing this, they're asking all kids, teachers, and parents preparing for school to begin to encourage participation in the trust's Crayola Color Cycle and Elmer's Glue recycling program. As I understand it, the program started yesterday. You can take any of your used markers of any brand, clean, empty glue bottles or glue sticks to the Nature Store, which is located in Dart Park on South Church Street. That's in South Sound and the National Trust. And they will recycle them for free. What a great initiative to help keep our local communities free of plastic. Over on page 11 of the Cayman Compass, a few interesting stories there. A top story on that page is headlined, Rise in Mental Health Cases Create Concern. Mental health issues has been a great concern of many in our community for many years, from, you know, the top up down to the average citizen. This story basically focuses on the fact that all those persons, professionals who deal with mental health cases and issues have recognized that the number of cases is on the increase. So that's another very interesting story. But I'm going to talk a little bit more about that when we come back from our break, which is now due here on For the Record. I just would like to remind you that if you'd like to make a comment or you have a question this morning, or something you'd like to discuss, you can give us a call here on For the Record, toll-free at 1-800-534-8255. Digicel customers can call 949-6990, or you can WhatsApp or text, send us a WhatsApp text or voice note on 925-3261. I'm Donna Bush, filling in for Mr. Orrit Connor here on For the Record this morning. We'll be right back after these messages.
Sometimes things just don't go as planned. That's why you need Contractors All Risk Insurance Brokers. Ensure you're covered in the event of property damage and third-party injury or damage claims during your construction projects. And with Fidelity Insurance Brokers, you can be sure you are getting competitive pricing and superior customer service. Call us today for a free quote. Fidelity, we're good for you.
A pharmacy is where you go for medicine and for the pharmacist's advice on how to take them. Here at CTMH Doctors Hospital Pharmacy, our pharmacists are trusted health professionals whose job is to help people receive the best results out of their medicine. They know exactly what's in your prescriptions and will be happy to answer any of your questions. You can be sure that our pharmacists will see that your medicine is at the right strength, in the right dose, and will check that you yourself know how to take them or use them properly. Come in today for a consultation with our pharmacist at CTMH Doctors Hospital Pharmacy, where we care about your health.
At Seaboard Marine, customers often ask us questions about their shipments.
Hi, I'm thinking of buying a car from the States. Which port do you ship out of?
Hi, we ship out of Miami, Houston, and Brooklyn. Just let us know your port of choice and we can provide you with a quotation and answer any questions you may have on insuring and protecting your vehicle during its journey.
Shipping shore to shore, Seaboard.
System one loaded.
1-800-534-8255. What is on your mind when it comes to the government, independence, and the opposition? Issues that matter to you. 1-800-534-8255. Waiting to hear from you. For the Record, with your host, Aurette Connor.
And welcome back to the listening public to For the Record this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful Friday morning here in the Cayman Islands. I'm Donna Bush, sitting in for Mr. Aurette Connor through the third week of August. Before I went to the break, I was discussing a story on page 11 that spoke to the rise in mental health cases that's creating concern. The story is there to be read, but the gist of it is that healthcare professionals on the island are seeing that the numbers of cases as it relates to mental health issues on varying levels, varying degrees, you know, they're on the increase. So as everyone would be knowledgeable of, I know that the government is trying to get a mental health facility in place here in the Cayman Islands. It's been something that's been of concern to a lot of people over the years. But I know that they're actively pursuing that. I did get a WhatsApp message. I'm going to kind of breeze through it. It sounds like a very personal thing, but the person is concerned. So I'm just going to breeze through it. And I'm not quite sure that I can even comment on this, but just maybe just give some words of encouragement. Basically, the person was saying that a situation took place in East End 2 days ago between a landlord and a tenant, where the tenant was given notice of eviction and 2 months to leave the place. They refused to leave. The landlord actually put a lock on the door. The person removed the lock. The police was called. This person is saying nothing was done. They also said that it's known that the person suffers from mental health issues and has threatened the landlord as well as tenants. The person remains in the apartment. Again, nothing is being done. This person is saying that they don't understand why the person hasn't been removed from the apartment or taken to a facility that may be able to assist her better. You know, this is a very personal matter. Being someone who doesn't know all of the facts in this case, I really can't speak to it. But, you know, this certainly opens this up for discussion. If anybody out there is listening and would like to call or knows a reason why the police wouldn't enforce certain things, maybe they don't have the authority to in this type of case. I really don't know the facts, but again, if anybody out there is listening and would like to, you know, bring us up to speed on exactly why an incident like this would happen and nothing is being done, at least that we know of at this point, please give us a call at 1-800-534-8255, toll free. Of course, if you're a Digicel customer, you can call us at 949-6990. Or you can WhatsApp, text, or voice note us at 925-3261 here on For the Record. I apologize to the person who sent the message that I can't address it for you. I'm just not privy to all of the facts, and I really don't know enough about the tenant and landlord law to really give a comment. But we do have a caller on the line. Thank you for calling For the Record here this morning.
What a pleasant surprise. Good morning, Donna Bush. How are you doing?
Good morning. How are you? I'm cold, but I'm good. They have me cold. I'm cold. I need a wrap or something to cover me up here, but I'm wonderful. Thank you.
What is the air conditioning too high? Is that it?
Yeah, but you know, they have a lot of expensive equipment in here, so I know why they keep it high. You know, that's important. That's more important than me being cold, I can tell you that.
Well, I hope you warm up soon and you become as warm as you are as a human being. God bless you.
Oh,
God.
Thank you. Is this Quincy?
Exactly. Well, who else do you think it is?
Good morning, Quincy. How are you? One of my favorite people.
Well, I'm good. I'm good. I choose to say that I'm good because the glass is half full, not half empty. I'm thankful.
Ah, all right. So what's going on? What's on your mind this morning? Quincy, are you there? Okay, it sounds like we may have lost Quincy Brown from the BRAC there. Hopefully he'll call back and we can open the line up once again for discussion. Let's move back to the Cayman Compass and all the stories that they have in the Friday edition. On page 11, again, at the bottom of that page, it says Key Club members win awards. Now, I don't know how many of you out there listening were actually members of the Key Club. I remember going to the Cayman Islands High School when it was called the Cayman Islands High School many, many moons ago. And I was actually a Key Club member. And I just enjoy it. I remember it helping me with my speaking abilities. I remember being a part of a club that you felt you could make a difference in your school. I have to say, though, the young people these days, because of, you know, the development of things like social media and, being a part of a wider scaled operation and organization such as the Key Club, you know, worldwide, that the young people have so many more opportunities these days. I mean, they're actually attending conferences overseas. They're getting the opportunities to network with people from around the world. My, how times have changed. And I really, really hope that young people that are involved in organizations and clubs like the Key Club really grab onto it and embrace the opportunity that they've been given and enjoy the fact that, you know, persons like myself who may have been part of such organizations many decades ago didn't have those same opportunities. So embrace it, enjoy it, be happy that you're given these opportunities. The story just basically talks about the actual Key Club and the fact that they went away in July and to a conference in Orlando, Florida, I believe it is. They attended some training workshops. John Gray High School, the Key Club there, the story says, stood out with Maxine Eldemeyer receiving the Jack Gander Outstanding Faculty Advisor Award. So congratulations to her. Congratulations, actually, to all of the Key Club members that went away to represent Key Club at the John Gray High School. So some great things happening in our community that, you know, sometimes we just don't stop long enough to really appreciate and keep our minds on. And it's just a great story. So over on page 13 is another wonderful story. It's headline, Traditional Music Groups Release Album. When I look at the two photos that's on the page, one is of the Cayman Folk Singers. If you're familiar with them, you know, you will know that all age groups are represented in this group of men and women, as well as they're so talented, so wonderful to watch. If you've never had the opportunity and you have the opportunity coming up, I'm going to tell you about that in a second, you should go out and listen to the Cayman Folk Singers. The picture to the right is of the Northside Kitchen Band. These men from Northside have put together a band using their talent, playing with the violin, the guitar, the drums, and to bring life back to traditional Caymanian music. So guess what? These two groups have come together with the help of the Cayman Islands National Cultural Foundation. And they're going to release a double album that's featuring both of them with popular traditional Cayman Islands music between the Cayman Islands Folk Singers and the Northside Kitchen Band. It's going to be released next week. Now, the Cayman National Cultural Foundation will be hosting a release party that's taking place, listen, at the Grand Ole House on Thursday. That's next Thursday, August 16th, to celebrate the launch of the album, which is titled Come Back Home. Now, the double CD features songs such as Gummy Yard, Cardeal Gone, To Cuba, Beef and Cane Peace. Yeah, those are just some of the songs that's on this double album. I encourage you, if you can, to go out and support this great, great, what promises to be a great evening. It all is going to be happening again next Thursday at the Grand Ole House. It starts at 6 o'clock with a cocktail reception followed by a dinner, a sit-down dinner. Tickets for the event are at Grand Ole House. It's $60 per person, but it includes a copy of the album, appetizers, a Cayman-style buffet dinner. There'll be live performances by the folk singers and Palante Jazz Band throughout the evening. For more information, you can contact the CNCF, that's the Cayman National Cultural Foundation, at 949-5477, or email cncf@artscayman.org. All right, so we have a caller on the line. Thank you for calling For the Record. Do you have a question or something you'd like to discuss with us this morning?
Absolutely. It's Quincy again, Donna. How are you doing?
I'm good, Quincy. Glad you could rejoin us.
Yes, let's try it this time. Hopefully there'll be no more drop calls, as they say.
Okay, so what's going on?
Well, right. Now, listen, that's a very good double CD that's been released by the foundation, you know.
Yes, foundation. Yes,
and
yes.
I encourage everybody to get a copy because the Cayman Islands folk singers and the Northside Kitchen Band, even though they're separate entities, they do their bit to preserve the Caymanian sound, the traditional sound. So
yeah.
I encourage people to purchase the CDs and go out to the launch as well. I'm in the BRAC, as you know, so
yeah,
you will miss out. But
definitely to purchase the CDs. I mean, they're great gifts, and I think it's a must-have for anybody that's, you know, that really takes their culture, the Caymanian culture and heritage, to heart. So I agree with you 1,000% there, Quincy.
There we go. Couldn't say it better myself. Now, will Cayman 27 or Radio Cayman be carrying the Miss Cayman pageant live? I don't think so.
No. Yeah. I can tell you that the Cayman Islands Government TV channel will be recording the event. You know, with the height of social media, you know there are going to be people who are going to be streaming the pageant. We're planning on running a very tight show. So this won't be, you know, every year, you know, we've heard people complain about, oh, the show is too long, you know, yada, yada, yada. It's a very, very tight show. I've worked on the script, so we need to keep it tight so that people can, you know, have a new Miss Cayman Islands representing us within a few hours. So,
absolutely, Donna.
Yeah.
I'm sure it'll be brilliant. And I'm not calling to critique. I'm only calling to perhaps say that it's just a little disappointing that the average person won't be able to attend because $75 is rather steep. And of course, taking it to the Westin now, a new location, I see it as pricing it so that only the elite can attend. But that's not your fault. It's the organizers, I suppose. And
if you could stick a pin there for a second, and I mean, there's a very fine line with my roles here this morning because I am filling in on this show for Mr. Orrit Connor, but I also right. happen to be a member, an executive member of the Miss Cayman Islands Committee. So what I would say to you, Quincy, and to the listening public is, you know, there's a lot of things that go on behind the scenes, and yes, you know, yeah. most people or many people would see that it's they can't stretch that dollar to attend. But I can also tell you and the listening public this, that there was never any intention of having that price so that only certain people could attend. Again, there's a lot of dynamics that happen behind the scene. Obviously, smaller numbers of audience. I mean, we're talking about 5 to 550 people here. That would automatically allow us to raise the price. Again, I can't go too much into the details, but I'm just trying to tread on a fine line and said that, you know, say to the listening public that was never the intention. So that, you know, certain people can't come or so on and so forth. That would never, ever be our intention.
Thank you for that. And finally, I thank you for giving me this time. Finally, we're having part two of a variety concert on Cayman Brac. That's on August 25th. The Brac Community Theater Company, we're coming together to raise funds to bring an American guest speaker down in September to talk to our young people. So part two is Saturday, August 25th at the Aston Ready Civic Center. Donna, thank you for taking my call. Have a wonderful day, ma'am.
No worries. Quincy, quickly, yes? You're talking about the part two Brac Community Theater Company having this event on August 25th. Where can I send people to get more details?
Absolutely. Well, now, there is no advanced ticket sales, so you get the tickets the night of the event.
Okay.
Which is at the Aston Ready Civic Center.
Okay. What time?
The gates open at 7 o'clock, mm-hmm. and showtime is at 7:30 p.m. That's Saturday, August 25th. For more information, you can call 924-8446. We're going to have persons like Ash Suki and friends. We're going to have Cordell Smith, Greta Tatum, myself, and a few more surprises as well. We're raising money to bring down motivational guest speaker Rich Barnes from Boston, Massachusetts,
right.
coming to our school to talk about the dangers of drugs and alcohol. So it's a motivational speaker coming down. But to get him here, we need to raise funds. So it's part two. We had one on July 28th.
All right. Quincy, thank you so much for that bit of information, and I will certainly reiterate it to our listening public.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity, Ms. Donna.
No worries. Have a wonderful weekend.
And you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. So there you have it for persons who live on the Brac, a part two taking place at the Aston Ruddy Center on August. That's Saturday, August 25th. Gates open at 7 p.m. Showtime is at 7:30. Quincy was just telling us, giving us a lineup of who's going to be participating. And I can almost assure you that I won't be there, but it's going to be an evening filled with laughter. So it's the Brac Community Theater Company. Go out and support them. For more details, you can call 924-8446. Okay, we have another caller on the line here. And for the record, do you have a question or a comment this morning? And thank you for calling the show.
Good morning, Donna Bush. This is Kenneth Bryan. How are you?
Good morning, Kenneth. I am great. How are you?
I am blessed. Thank you so much.
That's great. What's up?
Firstly, you know I love you to death, and that will never, ever change. You've been such an influence on my life and my career, and I want to thank you forever and ever for that.
But something just came up that
Quincy said that I fundamentally support in respect to the reality of what has now come to light about the cost and the effect it would have on the average person from having the opportunity to see the crowning and the slashing of the person who represents us from a global standpoint in beauty and representation of what Cayman stands for.
Mm-hmm.
Though you've just expressed it wasn't the committee's plan or hope that it would be so expensive, but we cannot shy away from the realities. The perception is now going to be that of only those who have that kind of money will have the opportunity to watch and see that experience, which is a very important one. Ms. Cayman and what it's done for us over the years and decades has been very important to many people, young ladies particularly, the opportunity to see I can be an ambassador for my country, to sit there and watch and see the words that come out of the lady's mouth. Now, obviously, that cost is going to hinder many of them to do that. And the perception of it being an elite pageant will be one that is perceived. And I can't see why it wouldn't be perceived that way, and it'd be justified to perceive that way. So my question is, after I've said all of that, is you can't air it or say so, but can you tell me who to question as to why, particularly because it's sponsored by the government, why it was put to the Westin, and secondly, why that price point was taken? Because the disadvantages of those factors are going to hinder the average young lady who inspires to be a Miss Cayman, an ambassador, will no longer be able to see that experience. I don't know if this is the plan moving forward, but I definitely know they're going to miss the experience now, because the average little girl from my community cannot afford $75 to go watch her beauty queen be crowned and slashed.
Kenneth, I thank you for sharing your feelings on the show. Like I mentioned earlier, as a member, an executive member of the committee on the exec team and my role this morning here on For the Record, there's a very fine line for me. So I would kindly refer you to our chairperson, who's Miss Derry Dakers-Lee. I'm more than happy to share her details offline so that she can explain to you why we came to this decision. And you know, we're all grown professional people. And if there's any consolation that she can offer, I'm sure that she will. And I mean, there's always next year that we can take a look at this. But with the with the height of social media, like I explained earlier, there's not going to be a lot that's going to be missed, because I'm almost 100% sure that in real time, persons will be able to log on to any computer and go on Facebook and see the show.
All right. Thank you so much, Donna. So if you, just after the show, just send me her details. That'll
I will.
Be great. All right.
I definitely will. Thanks for calling, Mr. Bryan. All right. So thank you to the callers there discussing a few things, one being the cost of the Miss Cayman Islands pageant tomorrow night, as well as Mr. Quincy Brown from the BRAC calling to tell us about part two, which is an event, fundraising event for the BRAC Community Theater Company. They're trying to raise funds to bring down a motivational speaker. I'll give you more details on that before we end the show in just a little while. However, right now we're going to take a break here on For the Record.
Did you hear that Vant Motors has your sale going on now, and you get your choice in the money you'll save on your new car or truck?
My sale? My choice? Really?
Yeah, and they have lots of cars on sale, some up to $7,000 off.
Sounds pretty good.
It gets even better. You can choose to take the full discount, or you can get some or all of it as cash back.
Extra cash back would be great.
Exactly, and you can even use the savings to extend your warranty or service plan, so you'll drive worry-free for years longer.
Another good idea.
If you want to upgrade with something like a new roof rack or backup camera, you can choose that too.
Wow, I get to choose?
Yeah, that's why it's your sale, your choice. Going on now at Vant Motors on Walker's Road, while stocks last.
Not all insurance is created equal, but who has the time to shop around? Take the guesswork out of your insurance coverage with Fidelity Insurance Brokers. Let us match you with the best coverage to suit your needs at a price to suit your wallet. Plus, get superior customer service from dedicated claims professionals to ensure speedy claims processing. Get your insurance through Fidelity Insurance Brokers. Call us today at 949-7822 for a free quote. Fidelity, we're good for you.
Hi, this is your reigning queen, Miss Cayman Islands Universe 2017, Anika Connolly. Join me on Saturday, 11th of August at the Westin Resort and Spa to find out which one of the seven beautiful contestants will take over my crown. I'm excited to announce that pageant tickets are now on sale at Sand Angels in Kamana Bay and Funky Tang's in Georgetown.
Come out on August 11th at the Westin to support us for
the Miss Cayman Islands Universe pageant.
There will be a cocktail reception at 6 p.m. and the show starts at 7 p.m. sharp. Lights, camera, glitz. We hope to see you there.
Initiating system.
For information that matters, For the Record with Orit Connor continues right now on Radio Cayman.
And welcome back to For the Record. I'm Donna Bush in for Mr. Orit Connor on this wonderful and beautiful Friday morning here in the Cayman Islands. A lot of things, lots of things happening this weekend, including the Miss Cayman Islands pageant that takes place tomorrow evening at the Westin Resort and Spa on West Bay Road, starting at 7 o'clock. Gates open at 6 o'clock. We have one caller on the line. Thank you for calling For the Record this Friday morning. Do you have a question or a comment for us?
Hello.
Yes, good morning. Thank you for calling For the Record, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning.
Great to hear you there, Ms. Donna.
Thank you. Thank you for calling us.
Yeah, your voice goes with it, with the weather, you know.
You're too kind. Thank you.
Anyway, I just want to confirm, are you discussing a specific subject this morning, or...
I am not discussing a specific subject. It's an open line, so please go ahead. If you have something you'd like for us to talk about, go right ahead.
Yes. Well, I just got a quick question.
Sure.
I'd just like to find out what is the law or regulation with regards to the UC putting a high-powered line through someone's private property without consulting them in order to facilitate an adjacent property developer with their or supplying them with electricity for their development.
Okay, so the property where the line is that property developed, or is it a vacant vacant property?
You're asking if where the line is placed to the individual's private property, if that's developed?
Yes, sir.
No, ma'am. It's not.
Okay. I really, in all honesty, I don't know what kinds of laws or regulations are in place for this. I do know from being a property owner myself that if, for instance, they want to put, they being CUC wants to install, let's say, a new light pole, which would carry lines from it or wires from it, on or near your property, that they do have to bring some type of a form for you to fill out and to say it's okay. And I'm telling you this because I've experienced it myself, and I, you know, I didn't approve of them putting a pole on my property that would carry lines, and they didn't do it. So I really can't answer the question except from personal experience to let you know that. What I would suggest, if you haven't done that so far, is to reach out to CUC officials and get some answers there. And I really apologize that I can't be of any more help to you, but I'm not in line with their or familiar with their law, what laws and regulations are in place as it relates to that.
You give me that answer has been a great help. I have reached out to CUC personnel.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't give me they sort of gave me a reason as to why it was placed, but it was the principle behind it, the way it was conducted. I wasn't contacted. I just observed the line being there at random. The line is overgrown, and I had the property cleared, but I had to avoid that area. I did contact CUC, and they said that they explain why they had placed the line there, but nevertheless, they didn't give me, any official answer or any official request.
Mm-hmm.
And they did promise that they would come and clear the line, which been some time now, but they haven't. So I just called just to find out. Can you say? Well, I guess there should be someone maybe in planning that can maybe give me an answer with regards to this question.
I don't know if somebody in planning would be able to do that, to be honest, but what I would suggest to you, if it were me, and I usually don't like to give my personal opinions on matters such as this, but if it were me, I would simply go to as high as I could in authority within Caribbean Utility Company. I would just reach out to the top, anybody that from the top that can obviously rectify the situation and give you the answers that you need. But I think it's probably safe to say that if permission wasn't granted and it is your property, that there has to be something that can be worked out. If you don't approve of it, it's your property. So I would, you may have talked to somebody who's, at a lower level, at the company, and really they weren't in a position to really give you the answer that would satisfy you. So I would reach out to management, upper management. That would be my next move.
Okay, Ms. Donnerville. I certainly appreciate your help. And
no worries.
You have a great weekend. And
you too.
All the best to you. And thanks again for your all your civic duties there. And I wish you all the best with the Kimon pageant there.
All righty. Thank you so much, caller. And have a wonderful weekend yourself. Thanks for calling.
Thank you. All the best.
Same to you, sir. All right, so an interesting question there. Sorry that I couldn't give the answer more, the caller more insight to an answer that certainly would appease him. But, you know, hopefully he will get some answers that will. All right. So we're just I'm just taking another further look into the Cayman Compass down in the sports area. Page 24, headline, young Cayman cyclist set for international racing debut. If you haven't read that story yet, I'm going to go over that in just a few minutes. But right now we're going to take a break here on For the Record on this Friday morning.
Satisfaction is guaranteed 24 hours a day, whether it's music or information.
From Grand Cayman to Cayman Brac to Little Cayman, we've got you covered.
You ever hear a thing like that?
Radio Cayman in the Cayman Islands.
Radio Cayman. Headline.
Radio Cayman's newsroom. Headline. These are the biggest stories right now.
On Wednesday, police received reports of two overnight burglaries of local churches, one in the Savannah area and one in Georgetown. Police would like to inform the public of a trend where churches are being targets of burglaries in recent weeks. In most of these instances, the culprits have made off with a small or undetermined amount of cash. Ryanair pilots are striking in five European countries, forcing the cancellation of a sixth of the firm's flights during the holiday season peak. The 24-hour walkout involves staff in Germany, Sweden, Ireland, Belgium, and the Netherlands. About 50,000 passengers are understood to have been told of cancellations on 400 flights. The action is the largest in a series of strikes over pay and conditions. And hundreds of Muslims in western China are engaged in a standoff with authorities to prevent their mosque from being demolished. Officials said the newly completed Grand Mosque had not been given proper building permits, but worshippers refused to back down. China is home to some 23 million Muslims, and Islam is prominent in that province. Those are your headlines. I'm Karsley Fuller.
Radio Cayman, the voice of the Cayman Islands.
What's happening in your community? News and information, music and more.
Radio Cayman.
You can find us. www.radiocayman.gov.ky. Like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Radio Cayman is your choice, your voice for today's biggest news.
Radio Cayman.
Initiating system.
For information that matter, For the Record with Orit Connor continues right now on Radio Cayman.
And welcome back to For the Record. I'm Donna Bush in for Mr. Orit Connor this Friday morning here in our beautiful Cayman Islands. A lot of things we have discussed this morning, particularly stories out of the Cayman Compass. But if you'd like to give us a call with a question or a comment, you can do so toll free at 1-800-534-8255. Our Digicel customers can call 949-6990, or if you'd like to WhatsApp, text us, or voice note, you can do that by at 925-3261. Before I highlight the story, the sports story on page 24 of the Cayman Compass, I'd just like to remind our listeners out there of several events taking place this weekend. One is tomorrow. The Cayman Islands Civil Service Association will be at the Aston Ruddy Center on Cayman Brac from 9 to 1 p.m. That's the annual back-to-school supply giveaways to civil servants taking place on Cayman Brac again from 9 to 1 tomorrow. We have a caller on the air. Thank you for calling For the Record. Do you have a question or a comment?
Good morning, Donna.
Good morning. How are you?
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I am very thankful and highly blessed. And this, I am still so very proud of you for all of your achievements and all the many hats that you have worn and still wear.
Oh, thank you.
And you know who this is, I guess. You know who this is.
I don't. I'm so sorry. I hear so many voices all the time. I don't want
to
get...
Listen to me. Just tell your mommy, although we are so close, live so close together, I still can't get to her, but she know I love her too.
Okay, I will do that.
You know who this is, man. I normally say your middle name.
I can't remember. I'm so sorry. Please help me out here. Help me out.
Remember I say McDonough me? Remember I say that?
Yeah.
I'm the only one that says that.
Actually, a few people still say that, you know.
Okay.
Yeah. So how are you this morning? What would you like to talk about?
Very, very thankful and highly blessed. Highly, highly blessed.
I'm
God
happy.
Is so good. And he's good all the time.
All the time.
All the time he's good. Listen, about the launch of the CD, of the double CD.
Uh-huh.
It will be very, very helpful. I intend to go to the launch.
Yes.
And then I actually have my $60 put on side.
Okay.
And that comes from me doing my silver patch.
Ah.
So that would be very well spent.
Yes, yes.
And listen now, it will be very helpful for those that can't be there for the CNCF, if they could announce what would be the cost of the CD, by the way.
Okay.
Okay.
Fair enough. Yes, I think that's a fair request.
I kind of believe that they should have a good number of those.
Yes.
So if people that wanted to just get the CD, you know.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah,
well, I tell you what, I'm going to be back on this show on Monday, and I'm going to make it my business, as they would say, to find out, to get the answer to that question for you, because the event is not until next Thursday. But obviously, like you said, people will want to buy. They're not going to be attending the event. So I will get the answer to that question for the listening public.
Thank you very much. And you have a good one.
You too. And have a wonderful weekend.
All the time.
Okay. Bye-bye.
You too, and your mom and all the rest. Anna.
Thank you.
I said Anna.
It's okay. Bye.
I'll rest there, you know.
Thank you so much, caller. Have a wonderful weekend.
Yes.
Okay, bye-bye. All righty. So I just want to take a moment just to say thank you to all of our callers this morning. You've made this much easier for me, as I had no in-studio guests this morning. So thank you for calling and sharing your thoughts, as well as very important information with us. So thank you to everybody who's called so far. So the story on page 24 of the Cayman Compass is headline: Young Cayman Cyclist Set for International Racing Debut. When I look at the pictures of this young man who I don't know, his name is Josh Weaver. He is 16 years old, and he's been learning to become a racer, you know, a cyclist for a few years now. He will be 17 in November. But when I look at the pictures, it reminds me of all of our Caymanian cyclists who've come before him, like the Perry Marin and his brother, Craig Marin, and, you know, lots of other really good riders. And, you know, this is a sport that many people in our community, particularly many of our men at all age levels, participate in. I'm filling in for Mr. Orrit Connor, and he is an avid cyclist here on the island, along with our premier, the Honorable Alden McLaughlin. They stay fit that way, and you can often see them on the road. So I just wanted to highlight the story because, like I said, it's a great story. This young man is, he will represent Cayman internationally for the first time this weekend, as a matter of fact, in the Junior Caribbean Cycling Championships that are going to be taking place in beautiful Bermuda. So I just want to say congratulations to this young man for taking this step. Obviously, he's determined with the support of his father, who's seen in one of these pictures with him. And I think it's a bright and great future for this young man in the cycling arena if he continues down the road that he has. It's a pretty lengthy story. It's one, like a half a page long. It does mention people like Mr. Craig Marin, who I mentioned earlier. He's a three-time Olympian and the president of the Cayman Islands Cycling Association. And in this story, he says that it's very important for young cyclists to have structure as they mature in the sport. Weaver and the Forbes brothers, there are other brothers who compete this way as well, he said, will need dedicated coaching and training to progress to elite levels. So my hat's off to Mr. Marin and the Cycling Association for supporting these young people in reaching their dreams, and, you know, at the same time representing the Cayman Islands on the international stage. Hats off to them. A wonderful, wonderful story there. So also in the Compass, you know, their special feature that they have very often This one is Back to School. I've had some time to kind of look through it myself. A really great back to school supplement for parents, for teachers, for students, college students, high school students. A lot of advertising in here, but, you know, just really a great layout, an interesting layout of all of the tools and resources that are available as our children get ready to go back to school within a few weeks. So, you know, take a look through it. I'm seeing some great deals from some of the businesses here, some really great articles on things like after-school programs that are available, ways that you can help your child if they struggle with doing homework. It has some lunch ideas, some that I'm not too happy about because, you know, we need to try to encourage our young people to, our kids to eat as healthy as possible. It also outlines some school drives that are going on across the island that you may not have known about. Yeah, it also outlines supplies that persons can give to some of these school drives. And, you know, I always say, you know, you look at these lists and the average person will probably say, oh, well, I can't afford to, you know, get those things for my children, much less, you know, give to somebody else. But, you know, even if it's a pencil or a pack of pencils, which costs, you know, a dollar or less than a dollar, do what you can. It doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be an abundance of supplies. But the whole idea is just to give. And, you know, from personal experience of giving, you give and you receive, you know, abundantly. And if you do it with a good and clean heart, even more so, the blessings are multiplied. You know, so I would just encourage anybody that can give. I don't care if it's a pack of pencils, just do it. It also gives some tips on how to ease back into school, or if you're transitioning from one school to another, you're transitioning from one grade to another. So it gives some really, really great tips. Also, I see that the University College of the Cayman Islands actually has a full page ad in here, just also outlining ways in which students can be more successful at the college level, as well as outlining a list of all of the things that they do at the University College. It also tells us about some important dates that are taking place at the University College of the Cayman Islands. Over on page A10 of the special feature, the headline there says Life Champions Literacy for All. This is an organization that was born out of the concern about literacy levels in public education. If you're not familiar with this particular organization, it's a great, great organization made up of many volunteers who give back their time and ensuring that children in the Cayman Islands know how to read, that they are literate. Great, great program that you can read about on page A10, as well as if you'd like to get involved with LIFE, you can visit their website. It's LIFE, L-I-F-E .org.ky. As well, they're on social media at LIFE Cayman. So it just gives a little nugget of information saying that those who are interested in volunteering with fundraising projects or reading with students can email volunteer at life.org.ky. Again, that's volunteer at life.org.ky. Again, some of you may be saying to yourselves, oh, I don't have time to do that. I would love to do that, but I don't have time to do that. I would just encourage you to reach out to the people behind this great organization and find out. It may be an hour a month or an hour a week or whatever you can give back. It's just so important to do so. So don't just disregard it because you feel you may not have any time. An hour can make a whole lot of difference. A half hour can make an entirely different impact in life for a young person that you may be helping. Yeah, so that's all on page and a special feature of the Cayman Compass this Friday. Over on page A12, there's a new group that's tackling bullying. It's A great organization that was started up not too long ago. It's called United Against Bullying. At its launch, I actually happened to be one of the MCs that morning, an advocate for such an organization. I would just say to listeners out there, I'm sure that at some point, at some time in life, we've all been bullied in some way. Sometimes it's a lot more subtle than other times. But this is such an important organization for each and every one of us to really be a part of and support and back, and to encourage our young people to do so as well, so that they understand the impact that their actions may have against other children, as well as how to deal with situations that may arise when they are actually the victim here. So a great article on page A12 that talks about bullying. All right, I'm going to stick a pin there, and I will be back here on For the Record in just a few minutes. Please stay with us.
Did you hear that Vant Motors has your sale going on now? And you get your choice in the money you'll save on your new car or truck?
My sale? My choice? Really?
Yeah, and they have lots of cars on sale. Some up to $7,000 off.
Sounds pretty good.
It gets even better. You can choose to take the full discount, or you can get some or all of it as cash back.
Extra cash back would be great.
Exactly. And you can even use the savings to extend your warranty or service plan, so you'll drive worry-free for years longer.
Another good idea.
If you want to upgrade with something like a new roof rack or backup camera, you can choose that too.
Wow, I get to choose?
Yeah, that's why it's your sale, your choice. Going on now at Vant Motors on Walker's Road, while stocks last.
At Seaboard Marine, customers often ask us questions about their shipments.
Can you explain what a less-than-container load is for shipment and what your minimum charge is?
Sure. A less-than-container load, or LCL, is any overseas shipment that does not require the full space of a container. At Seaboard, we have great rates for small packages. Just let us know the dimensions of your package and we'll help you out from there.
Shipping shore to shore, Seaboard.
Are you feeling sick, but don't feel ill enough to go to the doctor? Ask your pharmacist for advice. Here at West Bay Pharmacy, our pharmacists have been trained to offer helpful, easy-to-understand advice on the treatment of everyday minor ailments for yourself and all the family. Anything from headaches, cough, and sore throat to cold sores, our pharmacists will know when medical help is needed and will not hesitate to refer you to your doctor if your symptoms demand it. Like doctors, our pharmacists have a professional code, which means all personal information you give them will be treated in the strictest confidence. Visit us today at West Bay Pharmacy, where we care about your health.
Initiating system.
For information that matter, For the Record with Orit Connor continues right now on Radio K-Man.
And welcome back to For the Record. Before we went to that short break, I was referring to an article on page A12 of the Cayman Compass and a special feature back to school edition. And this particular article addresses the issue of bullying. If you'd like more information on this particular organization or just to support them, you can go online to United Against Bullying. That's unitedagainstbullying.ky for more details there. Going over to page A13, it just reminds persons about the health screenings that are available as well as necessary for students who are entering into the school system. Over on page A14, lunchbox safety. It just gives a number of ideas and tips on packing lunches to go to school, to send your child to school with. Healthy grocery shopping lists. I like that because, like I said, the fast food world, you know, nothing against fast food. I mean, they're in a business too. But it has taken over. I mean, it's taken over the lives of most people who are very busy these days. So, you know, if we can just rethink how we do things and really do our part in ensuring that we have healthy kids or healthier kids and ourselves too, you know, living and eating healthier, it certainly helps, right? We could go on and on for days about that. Also, on page A16, strategies to manage digital workflow. And it talks about the distractions. It says are endless, and here's how to help your kids cope. As a mother of a teenager, I have to mindfully always remind my teenager to get off the phone because they're always on these apps and playing games and chatting to friends and so on and so forth. So, you know, it's the path of least resistance is just to leave your child and let them do what they want to do when it comes to phone and the computers and what have you. But I would certainly encourage every parent out there to kind of find that balance for their kids and to make it a priority to, yes, allow them to use technology and their devices and so on and so forth, but at limited and varying times. It's so important. Because years down the road, I've seen some people just really regret the fact that they just left their children at you will because they're home and they're home and they're safe, and you know they can be on their phone and computers as long as they want to be, and it's been to the detriment. So, I would just encourage you to read that article on page A16. Over to page A17, best back to school apps. I would think that this is for the older kids, like the teenagers and particularly college age students. But it looks again like a really great article to read. Being road smart over on page 18 just talks about kids who may be walking on the roads after school and how they should be mindful of the traffic around them and others around them and how to be safe on the roads, as well as on page 820. It just kind of lays out, you know, reminders about the school zones, as well as the signage for drivers on the road. It's important that we're careful. I know we're not used to in the Cayman Islands having crowds and crowds of children on the road because we have a great bus system for our children. However, even more reason to be mindful because there might just be an off day where there are more children on the road, and because we're not used to it, we could end up, you know, causing harm to children on the road. So again, just a reminder, moving on from that, about some events that are taking place this weekend. The Farmers Market will be at the Ed Bush Field in West Bay from 8 o'clock tomorrow morning to 1 p.m. tomorrow afternoon, selling fresh fruits and vegetables. So West Bay residents, those living along these 7 Mile Beach corridor, closer to West Bay, you may want to go out there and get some fresh fruits and vegetables. I think that's a great idea. I don't know how long this has been going on or if it's just the start of it, but certainly I would encourage everyone who's listening out there to please go out and be a part of the farmers market at Ed Bush Field. Okay, we're going to take our another call here on For the Record. Caller, do you have a question or a comment? Okay, so we've lost a call. Please feel free to call back. Okay, so we've got a message here on WhatsApp. Basically, this person is talking about a story that's just come up as well. I'll read the message, and then if you're listening and you'd like to call and give some feedback, that would be great. So the message says, just a message here for the shareholders, board of directors, and management of CNB, that's Cayman National Bank, to please talk to us, the customers, and all Caymanians about the proposed sale of the bank to Republic Bank of TNT, that would be Trinidad and Tobago. The questions are, whose idea is this, and for what reason? I have yet to find one Caymanian who agrees with this. I read that story, partially read that story myself in the Compass earlier this week. I won't say what my personal thoughts are on this idea. However, if there's anybody out there listening who is privy to more information than was in that article, or just has a comment that they'd like to make about it, please give us a call here toll free now at 1-800-534-8255. For Digicel customers, you can call 949-6990 or you can WhatsApp by text or voicemail at 925-3261. Again, this is in relation to the proposed idea of the Republic Bank of Trinidad and Tobago purchasing the Cayman National Bank. Person sent a message saying that they've met no one who likes the idea and just wants some questions answered as to whose idea was it, so on and so forth. All right. So also in the Weekender section of the Cayman Compass, yes, the Weekender section of the Cayman Compass. I'm sorry. I'm just in the midst of trying to read some WhatsApp messages while I'm focusing on the Weekender section of the Compass, which really lists out entertainment events that are happening for the weekend. Of course, the front page of that, we've told you earlier about the Miss Cayman Islands contest where seven Caymanian young women will vie for the title of Miss Cayman Islands Universe 2018. The winner, who will go on to compete in the Miss Universe pageant being held in Bangkok, Thailand, later this year, actually on December 16th. And you'll be hearing more about that after this weekend's crowning. So best of luck to each one of these young women. I've had the opportunity of meeting and working with all of them, and they're all very special in their own way. So I just like to say, you know, congrats on a job well done, your dedication and your commitment. And I wish each and every one of you the very best of luck on Saturday night, tomorrow night. Okay, so in the B3 section of the Cayman Compass, headline says, Young Caymanian Combating Plastic Pollution. That draws my attention simply because I was telling you all earlier about the National Trust, who has started a recycling program. They're asking teachers and parents and so on and so forth to bring in their empty glue bottles, Elmer glue bottles, as well as their Crayola markers, and they will recycle them for free for them. So, yeah, on this particular article, it says right out of the gate, by 2025, it's estimated there will be 1 ton of plastic in the ocean for every 3 tons of fish. A sad reality. I mean, I'm not a numbers person, but, you know, just imagining that, it's just overwhelming for the brain to even comprehend. And you know, the Cayman Islands, like a lot of other nations, and particularly in our region, you know, we're dependent on the ocean. So I always think that we can always do our little part, no matter how small it is, how big it is. But this article talks about one young Caymanian who's joined the ranks of those striving to make Cayman plastic free. 20-year-old Estefania McDermott from Georgetown was inspired to target this form of pollution in the Cayman Islands after attending New Orleans's annual Ocean Heroes Boot Camp back in June. Created by environmental organizations such as Lonely Whale and Captain Planet Foundation, the boot camp was designed to equip young people with the tools and knowledge to take action against single-use plastics. This is a great, great story. This is actually an interview of Estefania about her experience, why she's doing this. So it's, you know, a Q&A. I'll just look at one of the questions that was asked of her and read to you her answer. The question was, what drew you into campaigning? She goes on to say, I was vocal on the issues that bothered me throughout my time in high school. Now I'm learning how to harness my power and use it correctly. I'm simply a girl who's brave enough to speak about the issues that torment my love, and that love is the ocean. I wouldn't call myself an activist, but rather an aware citizen who investigates the facts and is not afraid to speak up. I believe real activism and change is through education and uniting the community instead of getting mad at people. I try to guide them and open their eyes to the truth. Sounds like a very, very interesting read. I would encourage you to open the Cayman Compass, go to page B3 and read about that. On the page prior to that, B2, and going back to the Miss Cayman Islands pageant, if you don't know much about our contestants this year, the young women who have put themselves out there, you know, as public figures to compete in this rewarding experience and contest, you can read up about each one of them. That'll tell you a little bit about them as individuals. Okay, so over on page B5, Hemingway's Restaurant brings home the bacon. Didn't read the story, but I do remember this gentleman, the picture here, Peter Bacon. And without reading the story, I guess it means that he probably left and he's coming back to Hemingway's. So it sounds like a good read for persons who may want to, read that story. Okay, so we're going to end the show here for this morning. I will be back with you all on Monday, August the 13th, I believe. Yes. Bright and early in the morning here on For the Record. Hopefully we'll have a lot to talk about on For the Record for Monday. But until then, I'm your host, Donna Bush, filling in for Mr. Orrit Connor. I wish you a wonderful, a very safe, and a very productive weekend.
For the Record is brought to you by Fidelity Bank. For all your banking and pension needs, call or visit a Fidelity branch today. Vamped Motors, the only authorized Ford and Toyota dealership serving the Cayman Islands. And Cayman Pharmacy Group, with locations in West Base and Professional Pharmacy at CTMH Doctors Hospital. The Cayman Pharmacy Group has a location for you just around the corner. And Seaboard Marine. With over 35 shipping ports, find your shipping solution by calling Seaboard Marine at 949-4977.
Lean on me.